I see angels physically, and first time I remember seeing them, you know, I was lying in my cot as an infant, trying to reach up and catch them to play with them, but I never could. You know, if you're out on the street yourself and you see loads of people, but I see all of those people, and I see the guardian angel with them physically as well, regardless of the religion, and I would see other angels as well. It's just normal and natural to me. I see the angel of hope nowadays almost every single day, no matter where I am. He's like a beacon of light. He's like this huge, enormous flame. And within this flame, I see a faint appearance of a man. And he's holding this massive flame. The only way I can describe this flame is like, you know, the Olympic torch. But let me say, it's a billion times bigger than that. And there's just such love and compassion that comes from him, him beckoning to us. I was in LA about maybe a year ago, and the angel said to me, "Lorna, look ahead." And I saw lots of people, you know, and I saw their angels. And then in the distance, I see the angel of hope. And I saw that he was in front of a young man. And when the young man got closer, I was watching the angel of hope turning all the time and beckoning to him. And I saw the young man had a suit on him that actually looked shabby looking. And the angel of hope, I was being told, was giving him courage and strength, you know, to look for help. He was going for an interview, but he was feeling, you know, I can't really do this. And yet someone gave him the suit, had listened to their angel and gave him a suit to wear. And then all of a sudden, the young man just seemed to get energy. He started to walk faster as the angel of hope was beckoning to him. But another thing I saw was he reached into a bin as he passed to see was there anything there. I asked the angels, is he hungry? And I was told yes. And I was told later on, he did succeed in getting the job.